courage now. And realize when this world makes you crazy and you've taken all you can bear, just call me up, 'cause you know I'll be there. I see your true colors shining through, your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors, true colors, true colors are shining through. True colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors, true. Like a rainbow.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Show me your colors. Show me your rainbow. Show me your colors. Show me your rainbow.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Rick, please know that you and your wife and family are in our prayers and in our treatments. You mean a lot to us, you and Shemaine. But I have to tell you that when I hear your voice, I melt. So it's good to hear that. Our talk together today is rather eclectic. There's a couple different things I want to touch on. And maybe that's like fireworks after the weekend and after last night, so we'll maybe be right in line with each other on that. Coming through the holiday season, of course, there's lots of holidays and lots of things going on, and we honor all paths to the divine here, so we had fun celebrating lots of different things over the last 2 weeks, and actually over the last few months. I don't know if you realize it, but there are a lot of holidays and days of recognition that start November 1st. Well, actually, you might even go back as well. I'll say November 1st and then up through mid-January. I counted 45 of them at one point on WikiLeaks. I had a lot of fun going through what all that stuff was. But the last 2 weeks for us have been fun, they've been enlightening, and they've been a little exhausting. But it's all been good exhaust. I put on Facebook this morning that I have not had any alcohol this weekend. Go that too much to do. I'm not drinking till Tuesday. I'm going to go buy a bottle of champagne. So whatever comes out of the lips today is just from what's gone on. So lots of holidays and things. One friend seriously put 25 specific holidays that are most recognizable. But like I say, I counted a lot of them. And the major theme that comes out of these specific holidays over this time period is that there's a guiding light that is represented, or guiding principles and values for life. It's quite uniform. Light principles and values for living, we take this light, it comes forth, it comes from us, and we're going to use that light that we've kind of acquired and really brought up for us over the last few weeks, and we're going to work on bridging it into the new year. That was the title of the talk, Bridging the Light into the New Year, was that little character with the light kind of doing somersaults and flipping around that was on the website. But we take this light that we really have within us that not everybody knows about. And so these ceremonies and rituals that we've done over the past few weeks have been to kind of remind us that light is there and how to really get in touch with that again. This light is Well, we were created from the light. It's there to lead us and guide the way for us and for us to be able to kind of use it as our teacher when we want to. Christianity celebrates the birth of Jesus, and I like to add in there that it's really a recognition, well, for me, it's a recognition of the birth of the Christ consciousness. Kwanzaa, do we have anybody here that celebrates Kwanzaa? Or recognizes it? Yeah, it's very fascinating, actually. We want to try to do something with that next year when we have more time. And I'll see how many things I can volunteer for next December. And Kwanzaa signifies seven principles of life and culture that go over 7 days. Hanukkah, the celebration of light for 8 days. And one I didn't know, Bodhi Day. Do you know that? Is in December. It's the day Buddha experienced enlightenment. Happened in the month of December, they think. But I could go on for a long time. Ooh, especially that there's one on, well, I won't tell you what day it is. It's St. Lucia Day, St. Lucia Day. It's one of my favorites. It's a Swedish holiday celebration where a young woman with candles on her head brings lights and sweets to wake the children from the dark. This happens to be on my birthday, December 13th. It's one of my favorites. And I can tell you what, I am poetry in motion on a good day without fire dancing on my head, so I did not light the candles. But this is what she wears, and so I thought that's kind of cute. Did that for a project one time. I always often wondered if I'd ever get to wear it again. So you can look up that holiday on YouTube. It actually is quite fascinating, and it's a very, very old tradition in Sweden. So I digress. So like I said, there was a lot of holidays to look at and learn about. They even list holidays from some of your favorite TV shows. There was Drinking Day. I forget what they called that. But I want to acknowledge that we just came through a really fun time, lots of stuff. And so we had our solstice celebration, the Christmas service for the child of light, the world healing meditation about light and peace and harmony on the planet. And we're going to make that an annual event. We want to bring that back and make it big again. So mark your calendars for next early morning on New Year's Eve. And then last night, our burning bowl ceremony was fabulous. And it was a full room. So if you were a volunteer for any of those events over the past month, really, would you stand up so we can love on you a little bit? Look at that. Thank you. Because we can't do this without you, and you mean the world to us, and we do this for ourselves, and it really kind of brings community, and it really helps us really put on very nice events like that. There's another person that I really want to give real serious recognition to. And this person has been present for every event, no matter what. He gives of himself unconditionally, fully, no matter what. He tolerates all of our lack of understanding of what he does and his job, and we put him through all this stuff, and he figures it out and makes us look good. And it's that man in the back, it's Raj. And he's very shy. And he's got another big gig tonight at the Kingsbury Hall that's very important. So he's a busy man. So thank you. So here we are now, January 1st, the new year, ready to jump in, right? Right. Jump. Okay, so actually I've thought a lot about my personal thing about January is that it's like the cleanup month. Everything gets put away, trying to pick up all the needles. I used to remember vacuuming needles in the rug. That was really fun. One time, my husband decided that it was so messy to take the natural tree down and drag it through the living room and out the front door, and all those leaves and, you know, the little needles and stuff would pop off, right? So he decided to actually cut it up on the living room floor. Just saying, he wasn't the one then that had to go try to then clean up not only the needles, but all the other wood chippings for 6 months. So, anybody have a cat on a Christmas tree? That's always fun. So, January for me is the cleanup month, get everything put away, and I actually then use it as that time of reflection. You know, the whole season kind of really supports you really thinking about, now what did I just come through? And there are these important rituals, and everything supports you really kind of closing the shutters and kind of huddling in and wrapping up and really going into your own place of darkness and surrender. And, you know, where am I going this year? And what am I going to do with that? So the whole time of January really becomes that for me, usually. And then the year starts maybe end of January and February 1st. And so I used to actually do my own little ritual on February 1st because I felt more settled and more together and more grounded by that point. And so that was important for me. So it's good to find our own little rituals for our own life that are valuable for us. So we've got some other things kind of starting, even though we just come through the holiday season and we want to kind of rest for a little bit. We've got a lot of things kind of popping over the next few weeks, next few months, actually. It's going to be a very busy time. Our philosophy of science of mind, you know, coming through just grabbing the light, right? We've got our philosophy of science of mind, which is also a path of principles. We've talked about these other rituals and faith pathways were light, principles, and values. So our science of mind is a pathway of principles to reveal our own light within. And that comes from that divine source, no matter what we call it, source creator, source energy, spirit, God, that still small voice within. So that allows us to find our light. It comes forward to guide us and to remind us where we came from, what we are, who we are, and that we're never alone, and that we can make a choice about what we want to be. So we find our own awareness in this light. It's not something, actually, that everybody is aware of, and it's not something where the person next to you can go, hey, did you know that you have a light inside of you and it can guide you and help you grow and be with you every day? Really, no kidding. And then you're going to look at that person and go, what? It's dark down there. No, there's nothing down there. Leave me alone. So we have to discover this by ourselves. We have to discover that we're ready for this light, this thing within us. We have to discover when we're ready to see it and to trust it. Trusting it is a whole nother issue, and to let it guide us. Younger people today, I'm finding, are wired differently. You know, some of our churches are actually not as big as they used to be, kind of declining, because the younger people want to gather differently in different places and different times of the week. But you know what? They're every bit of spirit. They're actually more spiritual in certain respects. A lot of us had to fall on our face first to find out there was something else going on, or that we could find that light. But a lot of young people are strong. The light is powerful. And our organization, it has a big movement of young people coming up that are working with this whole element and learning to do their own thing. We find that research has been done that these young people even gather their own spiritual groups at the gym or, you know, at their favorite little bar, but they're talking about it. And it's there, and they're figuring out how to work it. So it's different for everybody. The sequence of solstice and Christmas together for us, again, about light, I keep repeating myself, that baby Jesus carried the light. Jesus, the man, taught us how to use the light and brought us the Christ consciousness that helps us to grow as the light. The solstice ceremony reminds us that every year there's a natural time that resonates with the importance to go within, into our own darkness, our own solitude, our silence, and to reflect about our life and who we are, and that we have the opportunity to be reborn ourselves. As that outer light returns, we are born with that. The deep winter, again, supports that feeling of just really taking that in and working with it. It's kind of like shampoo, rinse, style, repeat. The cycle comes around every year, right? You've got Christmas, and then we go inside in the deep, in the dark, and then we come back out with the light. Shampoo, rinse, repeat. Just remember that. Gosh. So here we go now. New year, new light. We have this new thing within us. We are stronger. We are brighter. We released what doesn't work for us for the past year. And now we get to look forward. What is going to come forward that represents who we are and who we want to be? What's the vibration? What's the energy? What's the energetic that's going to come forward to allow us to be what we want to be for the coming year? I talked to so many people recently that, and even on the whole Facebook thing, social media, they were really, 2016 was not a good year for a lot of things and a lot of people. And I have such a strong feeling about 2017 that there's something really different shifting and changing. And that a lot of people I knew moved around a lot or were moved when they really didn't want to be moved. And so it was like Spirit was reaching down, kind of picking people up and putting them where it thought they should be if they hadn't figured it out by the end of the year. And so now we get this opportunity to really find out where we're going and make a choice about that. But there's this whole energetics that seems to be supporting us in that movement. And I like that. I think it's going to be a good year for a lot of people. So this is the time that helps us do that. So how do we bridge this light? How do we be a bridge for the light into the next thing? Let me give you a few quotes. Always let your inner light shine. By doing so, you not only light a path for yourself, but you light a way for others. It's from Donald Hicks, the book Look Into the Stillness. If it feels like cracks are forming in your life, those cracks may be what is needed for the light within you to reveal itself. It's from Heidi Dupree, the other medicine that really works. So now let's shift gears a little bit. The theme for the Centers for Spiritual Living for 2007 for the organization is values-based spiritual living. The quote is, "We stand together in a shared commitment and devotion to our spiritual principles, practices, and values. As we learn and practice our philosophy, the science of mind, we live principle-centered, spirit-led lives and learn to turn our principles for guidance in all moments and all areas of our lives." Ernest Holmes writes, "The desire you have to be something, to do something, is a mental echo in your mind of the spirit which already exists within you. It is the impact of your divine and spiritual self upon your mental and psychological self. It is the spirit in you seeking an avenue of expression through you. The deep spiritual self, having all knowledge, having access to all power, being one with life. This is the self that can heal the sick and raise the dead. It is transcendent, triumphant self." That's from This Thing Called You. That's going to be one of the classes coming up soon. And I was going to teach it, and Reverend Barbara's going to teach it. And it's a fascinating class to really kind of dive into some of the real deep work of Ernest Holmes. It was one of his very first books, and there are a lot of people that really live that book as almost their own little Bible. It's wonderful. So the class will be fascinating. But that quote I just read was kind of long, so let me repeat it again because it's important. The desire you have to be something, to do something, is a mental echo in your mind of the spirit which already exists within you. So that's the light that we're talking about. It already lives within you. It is an impact of your divine and spiritual self upon your mental and psychological self. It is the spirit in you seeking an avenue of expression through you. It is the real self you would like to be, the deep spiritual self having all knowledge, having access to all power, being one with life. This is the self that can heal the sick and raise the dead. It is a transcendent, triumphant self. So, Reverend Barbara, myself, Mary Cordell, Teresa, the education team, are working on a schedule of workshops and classes that will begin very shortly. Linda just mentioned a lot of them and talked about them. So these classes and little workshops are being set up as guides and pathways that will first provide an easy understanding of what the light is within us, how we use it every day, and also how it uses us. Some of the language in the workshops will also work with the first four chapters of The Science of Mind, which is a normal set of talks in January for a lot of our churches, all of our centers and ministers. So the purpose of developing this program in this way and at this time is to provide five things.
So first, it is something quick and easy to jump into for learning and connecting with other people. It's a simple way to relate to science of mind and life. There's a percentage of Sunday attendees that love to come on Sundays, but they don't want to take an 8 to 10 week class to go, you know, deeper into the study of stuff. So Sunday is good. And these little workshops on after Sunday service, or these couple that we'll do through the week, are a simpler and quicker way to kind of jump into some of the information. The fourth thing is, the more informed we are about science of mind philosophy and our center, the more relatable we are to being a member of the center and growing ownership of the center. And fifth, we and the center and our friends and family here become more relatable as a group and as one. When we talk about one mind, one life that expresses through us, one of the things that we're hoping with these little workshops and stuff is that we come together in a more relatable way, recognizing that we are one. Yes? Okay. So the workshops and classes will get us more in touch with our own light, and that light of the divine that lives within us, that moves in us, and has its being in us. The distinct difference between science of mind and other New Thought philosophies is our spiritual mind treatment, our affirmative five-step prayer, which is the thing that we teach in the classes. Mary will be going over that. And it's also what our practitioners provide for you when you ask for prayer. So it's distinct because it is an affirmative prayer in the way that we speak it, in the way we teach it. Ernest Holmes says that if a spiritual mind treatment could be seen, it would be seen as a pathway of light. That's from a little book called Light, and it's all about the light. Light, light, light. So these little workshops are being put together for you. Reverend Barbara will be facilitating some of the Sunday, well, she'll be facilitating all of the hour, 1 hour workshops after the Sunday services that are going to happen. I'm teaching one, Mary's teaching one, Barbara also has another class on Monday nights that'll go for 2 hours at a time. And so all of this will begin in the next few weeks. Two start next week and two start the following week. Kelly, who is our amazing office person, is putting up all of the brochures and the information on the activities table for you to look at. And also, don't forget, like Linda said, if you sign up on Meetup and on Facebook and check the website, you are going to get blasted like you need to keep up on the information as this, all of this stuff comes out, and so you're right up on top of it so you won't miss anything. Years ago, we also provided classes during daylight hours, and we're looking to bring that back if people are interested. So let me think for a minute. I don't have to go out and drive in the dark when the roads might be slippery and I get tired. Oh, do you think anybody out there might want to take a daytime class? Raise your hand. Cool. So it doesn't work for everybody. Some people have families and jobs, which are really, really important. But if daytime works for you, Barbara would love to teach some classes during the daytime. And so one thing that's really important to remember is that if there's a class in the daytime that fits for people who don't work, that same class will be offered at night, so nobody's going to miss anything. But it just gives an extra different opportunity for people who are freer during the day. So that we're going to put that into motion. Not exactly sure when that will start, but I think it's going to start this in the next month or so. So thanks for giving me a show of hands on that. So there's a reason and a method that all of this is coming around right now, besides the reasons I mentioned a moment ago, which is about membership and well, it's really kind of getting together. We do want to increase the desire for membership. It's springtime soon. We're going to be coming into our annual meeting. This year it's going to be in April. Mark your calendars for that. If you're a member of the community, you get to vote on bylaws. You get to vote on the Leadership Council nominations and be a more integral part in some of those decisions. And it's not that you have to be a member. We love and work with everybody, member or not. But there is that aspect of membership that actually supports some of those other important things of voting and keeping the concentration of the center going. And that does present kind of a unique ownership for us, so we like that. People are nodding their heads, yes. Is there anything else I should say? No, okay. I miss things sometimes. So that's a big thing, big reason why we're kind of promoting this right now. So information is valuable, all of this. And these classes, these little workshops will provide more information for you if you don't want to get into the longer classes that are a little more intense. So they're geared for that. Educational information, personal growth, inner light, and then we get to feel more connected to each other and to the center. So I'll be continuing to provide social activities to keep people kind of shoulder to shoulder and have some fun and social interest. So it's like a fun web of light and connection that we weave. Yeah? Yeah. Good. And then we get to play. We get to learn and play. That's good. So here we are starting our new year. So with all of that, we just take it in. I want you to breathe in and breathe out. And I want you to breathe in and I want you to hold it. And let it out. And then I want you to breathe and I want you to close your eyes. And I want you to begin to feel and sense and imagine your own light. For all that's come forward over the last few weeks, in the talk, in the ceremony, in the ritual of light, feel your own light. See it inside right now. And breathe into it. And while you're there, I'll take us into prayer. I invite the practitioners to come forward if they want to, or they can sit in with their eyes closed. Yes. So there is light. There is that light within that is only that one light of all existence. It is the light, the I am, that has created this moment, and everything and every being. It is the light that shines brighter and brighter with every waking moment of awareness as it taps on our inner door to remind us who we are, and what we are, where we've come from, letting us know where we have the opportunity to go. Life is big. Life was meant to be enjoyed. Life was meant to expand, to allow each individual to expand into the divine purpose and choice that they came to be here. And with each choice, the individual is supported by the universe, by that light, by that very thing, that source creator, that love that has put us here, and how good it is. Today is a day of reaching into the new, of placing your foot one step in front, of taking the movement and the momentum from this day forward. Recognizing that with every step you take, that light lights the way before you. It makes the crooked path straight. Trust the light. Trusting the light, allowing it to guide and to grow and to bring to you all of your heart's desires and all that is required for life to be everything it can be. I call to this light knowing that as it surrounds each individual inside and out and embraces in love, I know that it surrounds this planet. I know that it fills and embraces every leader of this country and of every country and all of the minds that come together to work this planet. That impressive spirit is strong so that this next year coming turns into a vibration of harmony and that we move closer and closer to the ideal of a world that works for all, of a world of love that was meant to be that of harmony and that of good. And so I know that honoring each individual here, honoring our leaders, honoring all paths to the divine, all teachers, all minds recognize that it is all God, no matter what it looks like. It is all God and it is good. So we keep our hearts and minds in the truth, in that above and beyond any thought of ego, above in that place of love and wholeness. and we call it good. And for that, I know blessings and grace embrace every individual here and all of those in the hearts and minds of the individuals. And so it touches and moves out and spreads to the city and beyond. And it is good. And for that, I say yes. I release this. We claim it together and know it good and say, and so it is.